Ho
capito bene il lego.
Good stuff. Now go to Instagram.
There you go. That's Instagram. Good. Come
and
you on Instagram.
Stephen Marla Pearl. And then all you need to do is give a cheeky little follow because we are going to upload some very special behind the scenes footage of this very show that you're all about to see. Don't forget that up on the door. You're waiting until on stage. So I'll see you in a minute. Don't forget, that's Stephen Marla. Enjoy the show. It is going to blow your mind. Now, you can see all out there with your phones, do the photos and videos, and I'm ready. I'm going to come down and see some of you. Show. So I need a responsible adult to look after it, but Who is it going to be?
John.
Good to see you, John. How are you
doing? Lovely work, Ben, and my son, Kevin.
You having a good time?
Fantastic.
Good stuff. Unbelievable. Yes, now, John, here's the deal. At any moment in the show where you see something go down, it's fantastic. You press that red button. You're very impressive moments. Maybe it's something, the most magical moment in the show. You press that button. Maybe it's the funniest moment in the show. You press that button, and this show turns into party time. Thank you for taking part. It's good man. Now, we started the show off with a big illusion, but now we're going to do a smaller one. But remember, it is just that, an illusion. And it uses two pieces of newspaper. But remember, everything you see from now on isn't actually happening. Watch. See, some of you may be thinking that I'm tearing the newspaper in half. But I'm not. It is just an illusion. Some of you may be thinking that you're seeing me tear the newspaper into strips. But you're not, because it's just an illusion. Some of you at the back may be thinking you can hear me tearing the newspaper into bits. But you can't, because it's just an illusion. Very easy, please. Now look, you tell your friends, I showed you the bits, piece by piece, bit by bit, but I didn't, because it's just an illusion. And now it's my job to put the newspaper back together again. Watch. And now the newspaper is fully restored. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. No? You're thinking, Stephen, why would you do a trick so small like that in front of nearly 2,000 people? Well, there's a simple reason why I do that. You see, my granddad taught me how to do that trick when I was just 11 years old. And he said to me, Stephen, if you ever do a show in front of thousands of people, make sure you always do the newspaper trick. So, that's why I do it. But I don't want to bring the atmosphere down, because I know you're all here to have a good time. And I promise you, we're going to try and make sure you definitely have that. But sadly, my granddad passed away 2 weeks ago. What the? That's exactly what I'm going to do. Right, right, come this way.
And David, no, no. It's coming past
stay
now.
Stay out, stay out. Do not press that red button. Right, back on with the show. Right, here we go. Now, where are we? Right, sorry about this, everybody. That's unbelievable, that is. This is no joke. Seriously.
And David is at the front.
That could have killed me, that could have. Right. What have you got in here then? Let's have a little look in here, shall we?
Just there, singing.
Why would you have a flask in your bag?
It's fine
then. What's in there then?
Flasks are being expensive, are they? Hang on. Oh, a dirty ham and egg sandwich. Oh, some sweeties! Yes! Yes, someone, help yourself! Yeah, absolutely! No, 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 no!
Oh! Well, he's got his hand. He has some fruit in our look. He's there. He's coming back. Look.
Is it a different place? It's
not a man. It's not back in. Get out! And stay out! Let's just work this out. At the very start, I bounced the ball into yours to find three random people. It's important to remember that I don't control the music, and I certainly don't control where any of you sit. That ball hit three random people. The first person it stopped on thought of Michael Bublé. Then that other person said, we're going to go to Antigua. And finally, £10,000 and 2 pence. At the start of the show, I told you about this box. No one has been near it. And like I said at the start, I'm the only person with the keys. But what has it got inside? Let's find out. Let's look at the box.
Peaceful, lonely walls have changed for the last
few. I said to you, it would blow your mind. And trust me, it will. Look, inside, we have one. We have one glass tube that's sealed. Inside, we have a prediction. But what does it say? Well, it's time to find out. It says, you will go with Michael Bublé. But where would we go? We would go to Antigua. And we would spend £10,000 and 2p. We want more! We want more! We want more! No, I don't do that. Unless, of course, that's what you want. But I will leave it up to you. But for now, from me, Stephen Mulhern, goodbye! I did ask my dad for some advice, and I said, what should we do for the big finale? And all he said to me was, make sure you do something that all the family are going to remember, no matter how old or young they are. But whatever you do, do not sing. I said, why? He said, because you're crap. So, I'm not going to sing, but I'm going to show you something that I do think you're going to remember. This is our big finale, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed the show. Take a little look.
Dan, watch this.
When you try your best, but you don't succeed.
Dad, you've been singing.
When you get what you want, not what you need. You see, when I was younger, I always tried to make the impossible possible. Like using everyday items like these napkins and making something very special from them. Like a beautiful snowflake. Now, there's two ways of doing this trick. There's with applause, or the way we've just done it. No, that is not what you're going to remember. But hopefully, this is. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your break. And from me, Stephen Mulhern, and all the team, goodbye.